This is the second in the video introduction of the investment of the week. It feels a little more personalized, so we'll probably go this route. If you feel strongly against that, feel free to send a response via email. This is the week following Thanksgiving. We did not send out an investment of the week last week, knowing that we were all busy preparing for and then taking advantage of the time off. Hopefully you had a good time with friends and family, and you didn't spend the amount of time that I did with lights and getting boxes down for Christmas, as Thanksgiving ended so quickly and Christmas was upon us. It's kind of nice to be in that season and the lights and the feeling of Christmas. But that's not what this video is about, so I'll transition back to the whole point of this video. This week's investment is for those that are looking to keep the cost down and still have a good return without going into areas that might have significant turnover, potential vandalism, theft, etc. It is a 3-2, just over, it's 1,134 square feet. It was built in 1959 and it's currently priced at $98,000. The thing I like about this property is that there are some improvements that they've taken care of already. Dual pane windows has been recently painted into interiorly. AC is not original, etc. So there's some improvements that need to be made before this is rented, but they're not significant and the cost is low in that, or lower in that, the down payment would be just under $20,000. On this particular property, there's a cash flow of just under $300, depending upon what the rent proceeds and if you property manage. If you don't property manage, $350 with a conservative $900 a month rent. The cap rate is good at 8.5%, and the cash on cash is good as well at 12.5%. I love seeing these numbers, especially for those of us that are tracking our other investments in the stock market, certainly not bringing those yields. This week, again, we're trying to find properties along the spectrum from those that are looking for more conservative investment of their funds, and then those that are willing to and wanting to get newer properties that have a little potentially less upkeep. You'll notice, though, when you look at the cash flow, and if you've been tracking these, the amount of cash flow is not that different when you're getting under $150,000. It really comes down to how much you want to put down and then what you're willing for upkeep will be, and newness of the home. Next week we'll look to send out a property that has more of a handyman need, that is much less expensive because of that, where there's some sweat equity opportunity, potential rehab and resale, and certainly at least a rehab and rent. So that will be coming next week. Enjoy the analysis on this. If you have questions about this particular property or want to look at it, let me know via text or email, really either or sell, and we will set up a time to take a peek. So until next week, enjoy this analysis and we'll see you then.